The first of all, get used somehow when you're lying down, because even though we don't know that if you got the abdominal suppression after birth or not, especially this is your third birth, right? And also because it's kind of our first time to work on that, the postnatal exercise together, so it's best to be safe. Sideline and then lying on your back. So when you lie on your back, keep your knees bent 90 degrees. Again here, do not work anything on your abs, okay? Then use the two fingers. So basically, I think you're writing on the right hand side, right? So use your right hand, so the right index and the middle finger. First of all, check at your navel. So when you press down at the navel, do you feel like, oh, there is some bouncing? I can feel the quality of my muscles is there. And then, relaxing. So right now, step one, relax your abs. So step one, just relax your abs. Do not work on anything on your muscles just yet. So at the navel, then at the point two, spot two, above your navel by 3 inches, okay? And then at the point three, below the navel by 3 inches. For me, even though I never give birth, but doesn't mean I will not have the abdominal separation. Abdominal separation is can happen for the people who getting bigger real fast, who getting really fat and shrinking back, who smoke a lot, also that likelihood they're gonna have abdominal separation, and who also have the chronic back pain. When people have back pain like for long period of time, they also have the abdominal separation. This can happen to anyone, whether a woman or guy. So for me, when I check, I can feel that at my navel, I can feel the tension is quite good. It's bounced back. My upper abs, yeah, I can feel it's really good. My lower ab a little bit soft. So what about you? Okay, like it's softer, right? But the upper is a little bit, the tense is better. Okay, all right. Now, step two, okay? Use your left hand, support at the middle of your head. Again, don't work on your abs, okay? Do not do spinal imprint, do not squeeze your pubic floor muscle. Just lift the shoulder blades up like this. And then check at your navel and then lower your head down. We're gonna check just only one spot and down. Then again, keep your finger 3 inches above the navel. Inhale and exhale. Then you lift your head up. All right. And you lower the head down. Now, 3 inches below, inhale and exhale and check and down. And now tell me how you feel. Okay, all right. So you feel the better tension, right? Like you feel like a, okay, that's good. Now, we're gonna work on spinal imprint. So with the spinal imprint, inhale, you relax the belly. Exhale, draw the navel toward the spine and feel your spine touching the floor. Then from that, your left hand lift the head up and you shake the same. At your navel, 3 inches above, 3 inches below, and relax. Okay, that's good. Now you're gonna feel that it's gonna be really close. Core muscles combined with the four muscles. So when we exhale this time, we're gonna work on spinal imprint. Keep the abs in and inhale, squeezing your pubic floor muscles. Okay, and then try. You'll be surprised that you might not feel the gap at all. So, but you work on the keyword here, squeezing pubic floor muscles. All right. So inhale, be ready, and exhale, squeezing pubic floor muscles. Stomach in, lift your head up, check. You lower your head down first before you try the other spot. Now I'm gonna try the above. Inhale, exhale, spinal imprint and pubic floor muscles, squeeze and relax. Then you're gonna try 3 inches below your navel. Inhale, exhale, spinal imprint, pubic floor muscles, squeeze and shake and relax. So that's good. All right. So now, you can feel that. Did you feel the gap at your navel? Did you feel the gap above or below? Okay, like that, there is no gap above or below, right? That's cool. So now, and when you feel the gap, it's just only one finger or less than one finger. Okay, all right, cool. So that is quite like a good news. Why say good news? Yay! Some people, they have, right, yeah, some people, they got like the absolute separation. And we're talking about the absolute abdominal separation is more than 2 inches. Some people more than 3 inches. So when people working on the abs, and that is the reason. Check, okay, these 4 exercises you shall avoid after giving birth, unless you know that you have no abdominal separation. Okay, so check. This is number one that I don't want people to do immediately after they're giving birth. Sit up. So, not good at all. Instead that we think our abs gonna get stronger, no, you're gonna separate more because you put more tension to your abs. Number two, so many people doing this. This also put a lot of tension to the abs. Number three, like, oh shit, I see all of this on the YouTube, the leg lift, bicycle crunches, sit up, so all of this, and she told me what not to do, oh my goodness. And also, some people work on this, yes, they send on the YouTube, if I do the plank, it's gonna help me to strengthen my abs. To be honest, these 4 workouts put a lot of tension at your abs. And when you say the abs, I'm talking about your six-pack abs. This is that the abdominal muscles, the one as the superficial part. And these 4 workouts, they work more on that. So, and that part is the one that got the issue of abdominal separation. That's why first we're gonna avoid these 4 exercises until you feel that there is no gap between your abs, especially at your navel. But because of your is very mild, right? It's very less than one finger. So that's why, to be honest, you still allow to do the plank, but you need to work on spinal imprint. Sit up, bicycle crunch and the leg lift, that one avoid until
after 2 to 3 weeks, they come to check. We're gonna check again about the abdominal secretion. So usually by that time, they should close down by now. Mm-hmm. Some people it take longer than that because they exercise not correctly. Number two, they might not eating well. Number three, because I told you the age, how many baby you have, how much you sleep, what kind of food you eat, the quality of your connective tissue, all these factors is gonna affect that how fast or how slow your healing at your abdomen. Alright, so we're talking about awesome, but what else that I can work on my abs? We're gonna work on right now. So first, you still remember when we work to the side. So lying by your side, you can start with any side. So right now you're lying on your right, yeah? On your left. Yes, alright. Keep your knees together. Check, inhale. There is no space, right? And exhale, you lift your waistline up. So this you allow to work on because again, when working on the core, we are talking about the deep abdominal muscles. So inhale, lower the hip down and exhale up. Inhale and yes. So suck your belly in. And lift the waistline up when you exhale. Inhale, you relax. And exhale, you lift. Now, add a little bit more. Inhale, relax. And exhale. You lift your right knee up. And also, you lift. The waistline up, belly in. So inhale and exhale. Three, two, one more time and one. Now I'm gonna add even harder. So when you exhale, number one, your right knee up. Number two, your waistline up. Number three, pushing your right hand down towards the floor. Okay, so if I have the pillow here, you're gonna see that what I meant. So check on the pillow, okay? Inhale and exhale. So push my pillow down towards the floor. And inhale and relax. Exhale. So good. Pushing your right hand down to the ground. Right knee up, waistline up. Inhale, you relax. And exhale. Good. Inhale 2, 3, 4. Exhale 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Inhale 2, 3, 4. Exhale 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Inhale, you exhale and add more, try to squeeze your pelvic floor muscles, inhale, exhale, give me two more. One more time here, and so come up to the side plank. Another thing we're talking about, awesome just said that I should not do plan yet, but you're allowed to do side plan, okay? I recommend if you have the cushion or something, keep it between your knees, unless it's so far and you're just a little lazy, so that's fine. So keep your left shoulder above your left elbow, okay? And you can see that the space from the elbow, not too far from the hip. Some people, they go too far this way. So make sure that keep the elbows stay closer to the hip. Keep your right hand helping you. Try to use the whole hand or 10 finger help each other. Inhale, you be ready. Exhale, wrap the belly in and you lift the hip up. Good. Shake again. Do my shoulders still stay above my elbow or not? So, inhale down. That's good. And exhale, wrap your belly in and lift the hip up. So give me another 5 times. So we don't need to do much. We just want to feel like how much we can go today, yeah? So exhale up. Good. Take a deep breath. Four. Three. Yes. Two. One more time. And one. So keep your right hand up, lift the hip up higher, stay for 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Okay, before we change to the other side. So you sit, you keep your right knee to the front. Yes. Okay, alright, so still, you keep your left knee to the front, you keep your right knee to the back. Yes, so right, left hand down, right hand up. Yeah, we do at the same side by the way, so that is correct. So at the front is your left knee, yeah, and at the back is your right. Okay, so keep your right hand up, left hand down. Inhale here. And exhale. So feel the stretch at the side of your body. Inhale from the left. And exhale to the right. Now here, inhale, keep the hip up. Lift your body up. Look up towards ceiling. So right arm close to the right ear. Stay for 3. 2 and 1. Inhale and exhale, lower the hip down. Good job. So from here, my love, keep your right hand on the left knee and keep your left hand behind your back. Open the chest. You're gonna lift your body up And now try to twist. This time, allow yourself to twist even more from the shoulder, ribcage, belly. Look to the back wall. Stay for 3, 2, 1. And slowly from here, you might have a loop first. Your left hand still at the back. Your right hand still here at the left knee. I want you to turn your face to the left side and lower the ear side to side. So left ear close to the left shoulder. So you should feel the stretch at the right side of your neck. And then keep the right ear closer to your right shoulder. So you should feel the stretch at the left side of your neck. So basically, knock your head side to side, gently, slowly. 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Then back to the center. Good, good. All right. And now let's change to this side. So let's start first from lying by the side. So now you're lying on your right side. Yeah, keep your knee together. All right. So still remember here, yeah. Inhale, we relax the right side of our body. Exhale, you lift the right side up. And open the left knee. So inhale down, relax your waistline and knee. Exhale. So. We work out when we exhale. We relax when we inhale. So right now, inhale, relax. Exhale. Yes. Inhale, relax, and exhale, inhale, 3, 2, 1, exhale, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and relax. So, work on pushing. Yes. So how you feel? Oh, okay. All right. But you still able to do, yeah? Still feel fine. All right, cool. So this time, 3 things you need to do when you exhale, yeah? Number one, exhale, you're going to lift the waistline up. Number two, you're going to open the left knee. Number three, you're gonna push the left hand down. All right, so this is in one exhaling. We're gonna do for 5 exhale. Get ready. I just shake that from the pillow. You can see that how much I put my hand down. Inhale, relax. And exhale. Inhale, relax. Exhale, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Inhale, continue. Exhale, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 2. One more time. 5. And now side plank. Yeah. Check again, yeah? Right shoulder above your right elbow and keep the elbows not too far from the hip. Keep your left hand helping you. Inhale, you'll be ready. Exhale, wrap your belly in and lift the hip up. Very good. And lower the hip down. So inhale, we just be ready. We work out when we exhale. Exhale. Five. Inhale. Four. Three. Two. One more time. And one. Wrap it in. Keep your left hand up. Whew, stay for five. Four. Three. Two. One. And lower the hip down. And now, you keep your right knee to the front. Yes. And from here, three round here, right? Inhale. Exhale. Feel the stretching at the side of your body. And from here, lift the hip up, open the chest, look up towards ceiling, stay for three, two, and one. And slowly lower the hip down. So keep your left hand on your right knee and keep your right hand behind your hip. Lengthen the spine. Twist your body from your right shoulder, ribcage, belly, and look to the back wall. Stay for three deep breaths. And slowly back to the center. Now have a look here. From here, you're going to look to the right side and you're going to knock the head side to side. Lower the right ear close to the right shoulder. Inhale. Exhale. Lower the left ear close to the left shoulder. So feel the stretch at the sides of your neck. Six. Five. Four. Three. Two. And one. Then back to the center. So if you feel like sip the water and have a look. So the next one, we're gonna stay in all four. So now, my love here, instead that you relax the belly, I want you to draw the navel towards your spine. So check again. Belly relax, right? So, one, exhale. Now I'm gonna try to keep my camera to be a little closer. Ooh! Wow! Okay. So, maybe decided. I guess. So let's see again. You keep the shoulder above your hands, hips above the knee. There is no cat-cow stretch here, okay? What is a cat-cow stretch? So this is the cat, this is the cow, and the cat stretch. So we're not doing that. We concentrate on the belly. Inhale, belly relax. Exhale, you draw the navel towards spine. Inhale and exhale. Now use the technique the same. Inhale, two, three, four. Exhale, two, three, four, five, six. In
Inhale, 2, 3, 4. Exhale, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Inhale, 2, 3, 4. Exhale, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Inhale for 4. Exhale for 6, 7 or longer. Do this for the next 3 deep breaths. And relax. So that one we also call spinal imprint, when you try to suck the belly in and your back is become flatter. All right, for the next one we're going to work on the easy bird dog. Check again. Usually if I tell you that, hey, we're going to bring the arms up one by one, you know what, you can do 400 times, no problem at all. But the moment I told that, hey, before that, you're gonna keep your spinal imprint. You're gonna suck your belly in. Then you're gonna bring your arms up one by one. So you're gonna be like, ooh, shit, it's getting harder. Because why? We want the core to be engaged, number one, and we want the hip to stay steady without your hip moving. Inhale, you're gonna keep the right arm up, right arm close to the right ear, keep looking down. Exhale, lower the right hand down. Inhale, left hand up, left arm close to the left ear. Your gaze, look down. So, baby, you're gonna do this for 10 deep breaths. However, make sure draw the navel toward the spine, engaging your core all the time. Basically, spinal imprint at all time. Okay? So get ready, relax your belly first. And exhale, suck the belly in. And now, inhale, bring your right hand up, right arm close to the right ear. Keep looking down. Exhale, right hand up. Inhale, the other side. Exhale down. Keep swishing. Really feel that you keep your abs in, spinal imprint all the time. Five. Six. Seven. Eight, nine, 10, and relax your abs once you're done. And to circle the hip, and reverse, reverse. Alright, so one more. This time is gonna be your legs. Again, you've done this one before. First of all, stay in all four. Number two, draw the navel in so your back flat and be parallel to the floor. Number three, keep your left leg back. Check again, alright? This
I'm doing the spinal imprint. Some people did without spinal imprint. So make sure draw the number in. Lift your left leg up. Lift your right hand up. Tap the tip of your right hand and left toe down. So inhale up. Exhale down. Good. Inhale and exhale. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Relax. So this time, wagging the tail. Sway the hip side to side. And are you ready for the other side? So, keep your right leg back and don't forget spinal imprint and left hand straight to the front. Inhale, right leg, left hand. Exhale, tap. Belly in. Either you keep your eyes closed or looking down, okay? 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. And release. So from here, keep your knees apart and keep your toes together. So usually when we stretching in a child pose, we always stay in this, right? Stack the hand because you don't want the belly to touch the ground. But this time, totally relax your hands, your forearm, forehead. Totally relax on the floor. Inhale to the nose and sigh out to the mouth. Let go of all the tension that no longer serves you. The fatigues, the tiredness from so many sleepless nights. Any negative energy, maybe sometimes about the neck pain, shoulder pain, back pain. Let go those pain down to the ground. Allow the gravity to take care of your body. Allow our Mother Earth to nourish and support this body. So at the end of each exhale, you should feel that your body is melting down towards the ground. Slowly come to you.
Okay. All right. So, this
still have some more workout for the core. Today, I'm not really going to concentrate more on the standing, the squatting and lunge, but I concentrate more that what is this going to be the safe and correct exercise to work on strengthening the core, yeah? You learn how to shape the abdominal separation. Again, 3 points at the navel, 3 inches above the navel, 3 inches below the navel, and you use 2 fingers point down this way, yeah? Then when you shape, step one, you shape the quality, the tension of your connective tissue. Number two, you come with a chest lift, still don't work on the abdominal muscle yet. Number three, spinal imprint and chest lift and check, 3 points. Number four, the most important step, spinal imprint, belly in, pelvic floor muscles squeezing in and chest lift. So usually when upper floor muscles strong, the deep core muscle strong, the back muscle strong. This way is allow the abdominal separation to be healed faster, the gap to be narrow faster and easier. But if anyone have example, when they cough, when they laugh, when they sneeze, they feel they wet their pants. Like, oh, I'm laughing, but I feel that my pants is wet. Or I got a chronic back pain, or I feel like my breathing is still not working, it's still a shallow breath. All of this is the sign that one of the core muscle is still weak, or basically it's not strong enough. So that's why we need to work on the core muscles, yeah? Still not done yet. Okay, yeah, but anyway, it's quite common because of the relaxing hormone is still somehow somewhere all over your body. And it's gonna take a while to get rid of all of that remaining pregnancy hormone, right? So usually some people take up to 6 months, even a year. It's depend, just shake like some mother who do the breastfeeding, this kind of relaxing hormone is gone faster. Some mother that who kinda work out but in moderate, not too much, this kind of hormone is gone faster because the body is have the better circulation. Some mother drink a lot of water each and every day after the birth. So this is helping in terms of wash away the remaining hormone as well. Yeah. So which part that is easiest for you the most? Maybe drink the water, maybe working out in moderate, maybe breastfeed your baby for the next 2 years. Okay. All right, so, or you can do all three together. All right, so now, back to lying on your back once again. Remember the exercise you just finished now, when you stay in all four, just lying down and have a look, yeah? So, when you stay in all four, we do spinal imprint, and we do the single arm reach. Spinal imprint, and we do leg and opposite toe and hand tap, right? So these two exercises you're gonna do while you're lying on your back. First, spinal imprint. Second, tabletop position. When your knees bend 90 degrees and you keep your feet apart. Number three, so this exactly you stay in all four, right? And now you're gonna bring one arm up over the head. Keep your arm close to the ear. So remember here with spinal imprint, your spine touching the mat or the top. Your belly in or the top. So inhale, extend right arm up and exhale.
Inhale, right arm up, and exhale. Stop first. Some people feel the back pain here. Because of that, the easiest, I told you that just spinal imprint. You don't need to keep your feet above. Alright? Or some people, they might try to do only one side. So in this way, at least that because I'm not there, so you know that, alright, I won't hurt my back, but I work on the deep core muscle. So basically, let's modify together with me. So first, keep your feet apart, knees bend 90 degrees. Inhale, you'll be ready. Exhale, spinal imprint. And from that, lift your right leg up. Keep your right knee bent 90 degrees. Your arms up, realign your shoulder. So from here, bring your left hand, okay? Only the left arm up over the head. And exhale. Don't switch yet. You're going to work only on your left arm. Inhale, left arm move. And exhale, four, still same side, hey, left arm up, and exhale, three, two, and one more time, inhale, and exhale. And lower the right foot down. Inhale, be ready. Exhale, spinal imprint and keep your left leg up. Left knee bend 90 degrees. So this time work on your right shoulder. Inhale, right arm up over the head. Spinal imprint. Exhale, five. Four, keep your whole spine, touch the floor, spinal imprint, three, two, one, and relax. So now from here, we're gonna modify. So first, you don't need to bring your both legs up. We're going to bring only the arms up. Inhale and exhale. Woof. Opposite leg and opposite arm. So you might have a look again. So you can see that I dragged my leg. I didn't bring my foot up. But the thing is, it should not be that easy because with spinal imprint, we want the whole spine to touch the floor. So you can see that when I move my leg, I can move not that much because I move with the opposite arm. If I move fast, I create the space between back and the floor and I don't want that to happen. So inhale, leg and opposite arm. And you're like, oh yeah, she's right, it's not that easy. Inhale, arm and opposite feet, exhale. That's right, yeah, because we really engage the deep core muscles, that's why I think it's not that easy. Three, two, and one. Relax. No spinal imprint. Rock your knees side to side. Cool. Circle, just only your right hip, the right groin area. Five, four, three, two, one. Reverse. Five, four, three, two, one. Keep the right knee close to your chest. And keep your left leg straight down. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Turn the right knee to the left. Oh yeah, and then your face to the right side. 3, 2, 1. And back to the center. Now, circle the left hip. Small circle. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. So remember here, you don't need to do the spine pin yet. Just relax. And now, hug the left knee close to you, and keep your right leg straight. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And turn the left knee to the right side. And then back to the center. So from here, hug the knee close to your chest. Inhale and exhale. Lift the shoulder blades up. Keep your forehead close to the knees. Stay for 3, 2, 1. It's a time to give rewards to your body. Shavasana. So keep your legs apart. And keep your arms away from your body. Keep your feet apart from each other. And letting go your entire body weight down to the ground. And remember, give yourself the permission to move around. Right leg, left arm, body. Turn the head side to side. So move to the position that you feel comfortable the most. And now keep your eyes closed, softly and gently. Relax and soften muscles around your face. Now relax your head, relax back of your head, and let go the weight of your shoulders and your both arms down to the ground. And now relax your whole spine. So feel your upper back, middle back, lower back. Totally relax and make contact with the floor. Relax your chest. Relax your belly. And now bring your awareness to your hips, to the ground. Relax the groin area. And now let go the weight of your thigh. So your inner thigh, outer thigh, quadriceps or hamstrings down to the ground, knees, kneecaps,
your calf muscles, your ankle joints, your feet, all the way down to the tip of your ten toes. Totally relaxed. There are two options here. Whether you move your body to the position that you feel comfortable, or you already feel comfortable and you do your best not to move your body. Allow the gravity to pull the weight off your body down. Allow Mother Earth to take care each and every part in this form. If there is any part in your body you want to let go more, you might feel the little pain at the back, you might feel discomfort at your neck or your shoulders. So the next exhale, allow your out breath to wash away the pain and discomfort from that particular part. Out and away from this body. I'm going to count back from 5 to 1 here. So at number 1, you're going to